Hello everyone, welcome and a happy Sunday to all. Before we begin, I would like to give a shout out to my latest channel members, who are Eyes Open Edify, Hayes Jack, and Jason Leverett. Thank you for joining and supporting. Okay, today I will be talking about friends covert narcissists keep. These are friends that they may have for a lifetime, but it all depends on an important factor. So you will find out why they keep these types of friends, how they view them, and how they manage to keep these relationships going. Because narcissists are known to push people away in time, or they get found out for the evil, envious, fake people that they are. But also, we need to remember that covert narcissists can hide their true colors for a long time, especially when you're not deemed as a threat in any way. Meaning that your life cannot compare to theirs. So some of you may be friends with a narcissist and do not even know it. But by the end of this video, certain things will be made clear and you may be a bit wiser in knowing who your friends really are. Toxic people are everywhere, so whether they are narcissists or not, anyone who demonstrate these behaviors or thinking patterns I go through today are toxic and should be avoided where possible. Covert narcissists do not make good friends, partners, or anything, but interestingly enough, some of them manage to keep lifetime friends, people who stick with them through the years, who they are able to rely on, turn to, and have a shoulder to cry on. These are people aside from family, because what I have realized is that narcissists come in clusters where it's a parent or another sibling who is just as narcissistic as they are, and they work together as a team to defeat anyone who comes against them. But they also manage to keep a friend or two who remains loyal through the years. The closer you get to the covert narcissist, the more you uncover their twisted, selfish behaviors. That is why friendships may take a bit longer than romantic relationships when it comes to spotting a narcissist. In this video, I discuss the different reasons why a narcissist would want your friendship. Amongst those were a certain group of people who the narcissist does not consider to be competition. These are the people who look up to the narcissist and admire just about everything about them. These are people who have a long-distance relationship with the narcissist, or they are just naive about who the narcissist really is, or maybe even just as toxic as they are. But either way, their own personal success or achievements cannot compare to that of the narcissist, and they are convinced that the narcissist is smarter and better than them, and they feel very fortunate to be a friend of the narcissist. With these types of people, the narcissist is willing to reveal their vulnerabilities and imperfections, and this convinces them that the narcissist is genuine, terribly misunderstood, and always the victim. The truth of the matter is that the narcissist endures with this type of person as they think this person will never come up to their level. The narcissist does not envy this person, and in many cases, there is nothing to covet. So the narcissist does not see them as a threat or someone they should thrive to take down. It's actually very sad how the narcissist views these types of people, but that is the reality of the situation. These types of friends are always there, and they make the narcissist feel good about themselves on their lowest days or when they have no other sources of supply. These are friends that the narcissist would neglect when things are going well. Calls will be missed and text messages ignored, or they take ages to respond. And it is because the narcissist cares about no one. And if they have no need of you at the moment, you will be ignored. But as soon as things are not going so well, they make contact with lame excuses as to why they hadn't been in touch or why they were not returning calls or text messages. And the main lame excuse is usually how busy they are. After all, they are so successful and such an important person that time is a luxury. And they insinuate that you should feel special that they manage to make time in their busy schedule to fit you in. They would also say stuff like, "Oh, I'm just seeing your message," or "Sorry, your message got lost in all the messages I had to deal with." It's a never-ending list of excuses, but the truth is, the narcissist just doesn't have time for you. I have witnessed these relationships firsthand, and I remember that a narcissist was really down and calling this friend of hers who lived thousands of miles away. While the narcissist was going through their problems, they spoke every day. Every day, the friend was happy to talk to her to make her feel better about her situation and just keep her company. Then when things changed for the narcissist and she had a new circle of friends and other developments were happening in her life, she started complaining about this friend who keeps calling her every day, and she started ignoring some calls or calling back when she felt like it. But basically, the narcissist didn't need her anymore and didn't appreciate being bothered. Yet at the same time, the narcissist knew that this was a friend who looked up to her. So she gave her the extremely busy excuse to reduce the calls. Because until another crisis hits, the narcissist has no real need for her. Are they still friends? I'm sure they are. And it's because covert narcissists are very charming when they want to be, and they know how to give you just enough attention to keep you around. As soon as you start making any progress in your life, then will you see a side of the narcissist that you haven't seen before. They will become very petty and critical of you because now you have something worth envying. They hate your happiness. They hate when you find love and success. Friendships, like any other relationship with narcissists, are very one-sided. If you are doing better than them, they hate you for it. They cannot share in your happiness. They can only envy you. In order to remain a lifelong friend of a narcissist, you have to stay below them, always looking up at them or waddling behind them. As soon as you start making something of yourself, or even more people start liking you and appreciating you, the narcissist becomes jealous. They see you as a threat, and now they will want to destroy you. Narcissistic relationships are not worth keeping, and it doesn't matter who the narcissist is. We have to put some boundaries in place to protect ourselves from these people who only want to see us miserable, broken, and unhappy. As usual, I hope you all found this helpful. Please leave me a comment below. Many thanks for listening.